When we talk about the greatest crews in the history of hip-hop, the usual suspects quickly come to mind. But as we vigorously debate this most competitive topic, like an argument about our favorite sports teams, one crew had better be in the thick of the discussion.
And how do you see, you know, Ruff Ryders stack up against those other crews?
I mean, there's a lot of crews out there. I mean, you gotta look at it. We came from the streets. We wasn't even paying attention to none of these guys, man. They music was just music that we motivated us to do crime and have fun. The locks. I had a lot of projects in my backyard. So, you know, my sister went and got my brother, you know, because I went to see Puffy and a couple of people, and I got some traction out of it, but not the traction I wanted. My sister called my brother and he got involved because he was more flashy and into that whole Gordy situation, like how Puffy lights or whatever. We also have Mace too. And so, you know, my brother kind of bridged the gap with Puffy on that side. With that, and that's it. We opened the floodgates with that. Irv Gotti opened the doors for the other thing with Leo Cohen and Def Jam. And then I had my contract. I did a drawn up for DMX under that company with the production company. And then from there, you know, that's how I started. I signed, you know, the locks under a management agreement that they was already under a production agreement that we had to get them out of. That they was already locked in with some other cats that didn't want to let them out, but they wasn't really doing, they was doing work with them, but they couldn't really do the work that was really necessary. But DMX was under the record label. He was under the record label first. I had Special Effects. Then I flipped it back. My mom's, I was having, you know, I was in the house with my mom and she was watching this cowboy movie and it was called Ruff Ryders.
Right.
And then that's how I came up with the Ruff Ryder joint with my mom.
What's good? Okay.
How does it feel to create something out of love of music? You two battled each other. Swizz is one of my best friends. You're one of my best friends. I was nervous for both of y'all. It turned into this mega thing called Versus. Now, today, you announced a big, big move. And break it down to us so we can all know how did you make this move? Because a lot of people, I heard the number was 400 million.
I started Swizz at 12, right? Mm-hmm. My grandmother called me and told me they heard I was starting a record company. So Swizz tells his grandmother, the grandmother tells Swizz, your uncle is starting a record company because he was into music a lot at 12 years old. So she said, let's, you know, call your uncle. So he calls me. So I said, yeah, what's up with you? What you doing? He said, everything good. I want to get into this music business with you. I want to be down. I said, wait, are you doing good in school? He said, yeah. He said, no, I ain't doing all that great. I said, I can't do nothing with you if you ain't doing good in school.
Wow.
I said, we can't do nothing. He said, but if you can do better in school, then I can have you in the mix. Right. So that was my first interaction with Swizz.
In this day, y'all woke us up. Y'all woke up to sleep and tell you. Let's run!
We are one!
We are one!
We are one!
We are one.
Well, the mission is really to, you know, to provide an opportunity for the community to help the youth and mentoring them, as well as mediating, you know, with the police and the beefs in the community. So it's really just coming in, getting the brothers, the OGs, the pioneers, the youth to come together to actually man their own hood. So, you know, we got a 24-hour watch program we do it. We got four cities that we focus it on. And the community watch program is just like back in the days, like the OGs used to do. They used to come out and they used to mediate situations in their own community. The police came through, but they didn't, they wasn't, you know, people that they didn't know. Like, you know what I'm saying? It usually was people that the community watch in the community knew the people. Now you have the police coming into the into the communities that from other communities that don't understand the culture. And then they get it confused when they see a whole bunch of kids come together and they wilding out and the kids don't know them and they don't know the kids, so it's become a conflict. Right. So that's what we're doing. You know, we like the new guardian angels to this. You know, Ruff Ryders to the rescue, the new guardian angels.
And next time on RE Classics, Inside the Ruff Ryders.
My sister brought my brother in. My brother got in and we all came together to start to work together. My brother started to do the A&R. My sister was doing the business. Mm-hmm. I was overseeing a little bit of all the stuff. I bring all the different, doing the business with my sister and bringing, you know, different opportunities to table overseeing the business.
RE Classics, we will never forget.